Hey everybody, my name is Sagar Shetty. I'm a program manager on the Visual Studio Profiler team. In this video, I want to go over one of the main tools in your memory profiling toolkit, the .NET Object Allocation tool. So we're going to jump right into Visual Studio, launch the performance profiler. I've already done that. You can do that with the keyboard shortcut Alt F2 or debug and then click performance profiler. We're going to go over the .NET Object Allocation tool today. So I've already pre-selected that. And just going to hit start. So the app I've prepared for this demo is actually a WinForms app. So as you're going to see soon, it kind of generates a bunch of ellipses that represent prime numbers. And so if a number is prime, it'll be filled in green. Otherwise, it'll be yellow. The app should be coming up shortly. So the tool's been launched. We have a couple of graphs at the top. Live objects, the number of objects that are being created and are allocating memory. We have another graph with the change in objects and then private bytes as well. And so the app should be coming online soon. But yeah, these graphs are just going to be collecting some data. And once the app is online, I'll generate some prime numbers. Yep, the app's coming up now. And so, yeah, we have a min and max parameter. I'm just going to click generate. And as you can see, it kind of generates and creates this visual here. And the green ellipses represent the prime numbers, and the yellow ones are non-prime numbers. And so I'm just going to click generate a few times and just create some objects and allocate some memory. And then later on, we're going to go back into the report that the .NET Alloc tool creates and then kind of analyze that data and get some insights from there. So I've clicked generate a few times. I'm going to go ahead and stop this and let the tool load. And there are going to basically be a couple of different views we explore. One is the allocations view, which kind of goes over various allocation types. And for each of those types, it kind of shows us how much memory is being allocated. And we can click on those types, as you'll soon see, and then be able to go into the back traces and find the code pathways allocating those types. We're going to look at another view called the collections tab, which the team has been investing a lot of resources into. And that's kind of going over garbage collection, which I'll talk a little bit about, and kind of show you where garbage collection is occurring and some information about that. And then there's basically like a call trees and a functions view as well, which is kind of showing code pathways that are allocating a lot of memory. So we'll be going over all that in this video. So we're going to kind of walk through all four of these views here. As I mentioned previously, the allocations view, the call tree, the functions, and the collection kind of give you a high-level overview of what each one kind of talks about. So one quick tip with kind of our graphs at the top here, and this is kind of true across all of our profiling tools that have like these swim lanes, as we call it, is you can drag and click. And what that's going to do is essentially filter down the data in the corresponding tables at the bottom of the screen to just that time selected range. So that's a great little tip for you to kind of really focus in on a specific time slice, on a specific time range that you're really interested in, just because these tools really do collect a lot of data, which is why sometimes it'll take a little longer to load. And I'm going to flip over to the collections tab. And one thing to call out as well, just with the graphs, is if you notice this object delta graph in particular, there are kind of green bars and then these red bars. So green bars are kind of adding objects, more objects are being created. And as you can see here, these red bars, as it kind of indicates going downward, it's kind of a negative change. So these red bars actually indicate where garbage collection has occurred. And so garbage collection is kind of like a product of the .NET runtime. And so basically, it's almost like this automatic memory cleaning service that we have. And so it basically kind of combs through the stack and kind of looks at objects that maybe haven't been used in a while and are holding onto a lot of memory and kind of cleans that up for us. And so the collections view, it's loaded. I kind of want to speak to this a bit. Kind of gives us some information at every single point that garbage collection is occurring. So if I drag this up a little bit, we can see all the garbage collections that occurred in the time range, 1 through 6. We can kind of see the generation for garbage collection. So there are various versions of GC in terms of generations. And so some objects are held on for longer periods of time, and so they're promoted to later generations. And so the collections view really gives us a good overview on kind of all the different things happening within garbage collection at that particular point in time. Another quick tip, this table has a lot of data. And if you right click on any of these column headers, you'll see the full range of data points you can get. Definitely encourage everyone to play around with this. And so, yeah, you can definitely show more columns, hide columns you don't want, and kind of play around with that. So this is kind of the GC view in a nutshell. Want to flip the table a bit and kind of talk about some of the other views as well. So this is the allocations view. And so it kind of has two halves to it. And so on the left half is kind of the different allocation types. And so it has a bunch of different kind of data structures, classes, objects that are invoked, basically a bunch of allocation types. And if we double click on a specific type, what we get on the right side of the screen is essentially a backtrace, which is essentially showing us in our code where those objects of that type are being allocated. So this is going to load. And what I want to show here is we kind of have this ellipse class, this type, that's being allocated a lot. And I kind of want to go back to the source code where that's being allocated to kind of highlight an inefficiency in our code. So this backtrace is going to load, and it's essentially going to show us in our code where this ellipse class is allocating a ton of memory. And as I kind of mentioned before, with any of our charts, really kind of play around, right click on a lot of the column headings. You might find columns that are not shown by default that you'll be interested in. Yep. So the backtrace is loaded. And as we can see here, we kind of have an inverted call tree. And so the leaf node is at the top. And so this generate primes function seems interesting. It's doing quite a lot of allocations and bytes. And to go to source, it's really easy. You just right click and then click go to source. And so that's going to bring me to source. So it's great that we're right here within Visual Studio. We have access to the source code, and I can see within my generate primes function, we have this long for loop, and within that for loop, which is kind of running for all the numbers that I wanted to generate in that visualization, I'm creating a new ellipse object every single time. And so that's where a lot of memory is being allocated. So that's kind of a quick sneak peek in how you can kind of go back to source. To quickly touch up on some of the other views, we have the call tree and functions view as well. But basically, in summary, what they do is kind of show you the call tree and the different call stacks that occurred in your code and where all the memory is being allocated. And the functions view kind of pivots by a function level across all call stacks where your code is allocating a lot of memory. So in conclusion, that's the .NET object allocation tool. It's a great tool to have in your memory toolkit. It really shows you a lot of insights into garbage collection with the collections view. It allows you to filter by a variety of different parameters, whether allocation type or by function. And you can ultimately get back to your source code and figure out where to have optimizations. So hope that was helpful. Taught you a little bit about one of our profiling tools. We're generating tons of content on the Visual Studio YouTube sites and on docs and blogs and all of our tools. So for more information, go check out some of those sites as well. And yeah, happy profiling. Take care.